as I proceed to knock everything over. Make a big racket for the microphone.
Have you ever played Kerbal Space Program?
No, but everyone keeps telling me about it and implying that I should play it.
I think you have to, like, make a space program from scratch or something.
Yes, pretty much.
Which sounds awesome and frightfully frustrating at the same time.
Yes. Because I know, I played...
You get too into it.
I played the stupid little game at the Air and Space Museum as a kid where you build your own rocket. And I couldn't beat that stupid thing, so...
Stress and dead against all speed program games.
Yeah.
Did he just call you a horrible man? What?
Yeah, he said something horrible has happened.
You horrible man!
You horrible man!
There's a horrible man here to see you.
We'll venture to face the Lou Gehrig game.
He is very stressed.
Yeah. Because the mayor has that kind of authority.
Where do they hail from?
The Valley of Corrupted Gravity. Oh, like, what were we playing where, was it us that was talking about that, where gravity got broken or something? What was it, what did we play last week?
Singer Terrace?
No.
Resonance of Fate?
Yeah, gravity, so awful that gravity was, it was time.
Oh, yes.
It was time, that's time what it was which is even worse, because I could see gravity getting screwed up, but time, it's like, what?
Time get destroyed anymore?
The something about the rotation of the Earth's axis.
That's right, we screwed up time, that's right. And that's why I couldn't remember that, because I've never actually read the prologue before you did.
Maybe they just meant our measurement of time, but they made it sound like time
itself got screwed over because of pollution. Oh, hey, I do get another person. Oh, hey, Alki, how dare you touch my butt?
What?!
Who's Alki?
I don't see anyone.
Why would I dare to touch the button, kid? Like,
It's someone down there that's unrelated to Dart.
Yes. I was gonna say,
is this a woman?
Yeah, I'm too sexy for my shirt.
Who's the one yelling? Back? The person that we can't see?
Yes.
The one with the flappy arms. Yeah.
Whoa.
Hey,
is this supposed to be an attractive woman or like a buff woman?
She's supposed to be an attractive woman. I guess she's just all pixely.
And she's wearing a Slave Leia bikini for...
That's kinda, blue, yeah. Though. What's her name? Alki?
Meru.
Let's see.
I think Alki's the dude.
Blue!
As I retrieve the box so we can see what she's supposed to look like.
I'm looking.
And not pixel.
Oh, here we go. She's okay. She looks like she's like 12. It's the same picture. She looks like she's not... Is there like a bio for that person?
Well, I'm sure if we just watched the cutscene, but I'm sure there isn't, apparently. Nope.
Hey. Cosplay.
We've got to save Lynn!
She actually has, like, emotion on her face. I'm impressed with the PlayStation. I am very impressed.
Man, on here, I thought we finally got past the whole bastardization of
bastards, but nope, bastards are back.
What?
Remember at the start of this game, every 5 minutes someone was yelling bastard?
I guess I don't.
Go watch our first couple episodes and you'll remember that apparently Bale has a very large percentage of bastards.
Trust someone that's a raving lunatic?
Yes.
You know.
That's why I'm keeping my phone over here so it doesn't buzz the table.
Is she supposed to be a different species or just a, like from a different area of the world where it's okay to dress in nothing?
What, as opposed to the just normal outfits that all of our guys wear?
Well...
yeah, define normal.
You know... Normal's overrated. Alright, fine, whatever.
We need the permission of the king.
Oh, is this our excuse to go?
Permission. Oh, so now can we get to the king then?
Yeah, uh-huh. Now we have to wait for Fester, and Fester ushers us in.
Uncle Fester.
How do you know the king?
I can only think of the, like, Adam's Family animated series, Fester. Love that show.
That has been a long time.
They used to show it on Boomerang. There's good texture on those mountains.
Yes.
Scorpion.
It's almost like they're really there. Like I could go up and
you could just reach out and touch them.
Grab a rock and make it my special friend.
Make it my servant. Help me at all of my battles.
This is referring to a joke we were having off mic while you were gone.
Apparently, before you got here.
Rose was gonna kick a rock to level up, and she was gonna kick the rock so badassly that the rock would devote its life to her.
And then it would become a party member since it's a JRPG.
Anyone can be a party member in a JRPG.
Exactly, so the Rock was going to be a party
member. I would love if there were a JRPG where that were feasible, but the graphics would have to be so crappy, and it would have to be on such a huge disc for that to actually work, that any person in the world could be a party. And it would take like 10 years to develop.
Yeah, and you'd have to come out with conditions of, like, everyone would have, you have to do, fix
like
my
you just
problem.
Recruit, like, every single person, and the final boss fight is like... 1,000 or
no,
like
but because
1,000,
it's a JRPG, remember we have 1,000 people on our party, but
only
can only
three at a time, yeah.
Or four, depending on some of them.
Or
but
eight.
Yes.
Golden Sun.
No, but we want all of them. But that pit that because and if you can't, Matt is displeased.
Yeah, it's depressing. Say so, you know, the closest thing I think of is Skies of Arcadia, where you can recruit a bunch
even
of people.
Even Mass
your
Effect,
crew,
you
could
only have three people.
But... Oh, you're talking about that. I'm trying to think.
No,
let's
just in general.
Yeah.
In Mass Effect, you can only have two other people with you. Because it was always Shepard and two other people. Mm-hmm. And that's an American RPG.
But at least they had...
Only three people could fit on the shuttle.
Yeah. They had the vague excuse that, oh, the other people are actually not with you. They're on the ship. As opposed to we should assume that just off screen...
Yeah, or just
Shayna,
like all the rest of my party just standing there staring like, are you guys done fighting?
Shayna, Hashel, and Mary were like, oh, we're just over here.
Gonna be chilling, you know, let us know when you're done.
And the only game that did anything with that was some of the Tales games where it would be like, if you got attacked from behind, then the people not in your party were the ones you had to fight with. Because you had to be being they were in the back.
Spinning King!
Which was weird.
Yeah, no leg itchy.
See, that wasn't bad, except that meant you weren't playing the main character you played the entire rest of the game of, and you suddenly had to learn some new character's combat style. I did it in Tales of Symphonia, but I think the other Tales games do that, because there are places where you can get some like huge parties.
Usually about seven.
That's what we'll have to get you to play Skies of Arcadia.
I'm up for it eventually. I'm not sure.
How much more JRPG we can
have? Yeah, when I said I wanted to take about break
we play some real American games.
I wanted to take a break from Resident Evil, I don't think I meant, so let's play a whole JRPG. The intent was to play a quick first-person shooter.
Which, all the first-person shooters that are worth
considering Brick Bodyguard turned out to be a rather horrible idea.
That's the closest thing to a quick first-person shooter, and it's... And it didn't work out.
I meant first-person shooters are generally quick. They're,
fine, let's play Halo 4.
They're not huge games. Burning rush. I don't have it.
What Halo? I do.
I'm probably gonna pick up the Master Chief Collection, and then I'll get it that way.
Well, no, I mean, if we want to do that, if we want to cleanse your palate, we can play some Halo 4, then I can know what the fuck happens. I'm gonna have to do a Secret Service brick.
But I want to find out what happens with my Secret Service brick.
Bodyguard.
Does
he become a real boy?
Probably not. I'm betting he'll get betrayed at some point, though, and he'll probably save the president multiple times.
I'm just thinking of... just to save the president, someone just picks up the brick and just throws it at him.
Oh, yeah, here we go. He's like, hey, we should go see the king. Have you met him? And he's like, yeah, probably a couple times. He's like, oh, sweet, so you can get us in. He's like, no. He's like, I don't want it known that I'm here. I'm traveling as your guys' friend, not a king. And we're just like, you asshole. Plot development, really?
You have to
find another way in because Albert's like, no, I don't really feel like getting us in there. Fate of the world, all this crap. And he's just like, nah, I'm fine.
Flanagan, pick me up and throw me at the sniper now!
Sure thing, Brick Bodyguard!
We should make like a short film. That could be for the MoldyCrow.
Finally, something different.
I'm just imagining you take tofu and replace the tofu with a brick.
So, does somebody have a brick costume? Make like a brick costume out of like drywall so it looks realistic instead of like. Although tofu looks kind of wriggly. What the fuck just happened?
You can't enter the castle by doing that.
This guard looks like the worst equipped guard ever. It just looks like he's wearing shoulder pads and has a lance. And a skirt. I mean, I understand they don't look particularly trustworthy.
You are pretty!
You're like five times her size. Damn it, Albert! Is that the only... I guess this is the... Like, Albert? King Albert, this would be really easy.
Alright, you can just be like, this is my envoy.
I miss Lavitz.
Why?
He was more to the point. This guy is like, I don't want anybody to know who I am.
It's just like that random book I read said, the best of us never make it out.
What? Random book?
Yeah, I don't remember what it's called. It was about the Holocaust. It was depressing.
Oh, yeah. If you didn't know that going in, then
I knew it going in, but for some reason I remembered the quote, one of the quotes he said was like, the best of us didn't make it out, because the people who survived were the ones who, like,
connived and cheated and, like,
really gave up their friends,
well,
basically.
Fought for survival at the expense of other people.
Hello, Taffy.
We don't have such a cocktail.
She's a barmaid.
You should make one!
So a drink that, like, floats out over the glass while you drink it?
Forget about it.
Forget about it.
Forget about it.
What?
We're not that kind of bar.
What kind of bar?
The kind that says forget about it.
Apparently we are, because you just said it.
Okay, come on, you won't let me find Esther.
Make it be nighttime again.
I can't just do that. Oh, wait, I think I remember where he is. He's in one of the shops. He's in one of the shops.
You just keep telling yourself that, Josh.
He is in one of the, I think he's in one of the shops.
He's in one of the shops, please let him be in one of the shops, please!
I think he wants to buy the Saturn V.
Really?
No. He really doesn't, but I think he's in that one.
That would be amazing.
He's like, how much for that rocket?
How much for the top of that Saturn V rocket? I have the rest.
I built the rest. Yep.
If I
he actually
too.
Is kind of looking at it, though. He was kind of looking at it. Maybe he was here to buy that.
What?
Don't leave! We need you now!
Can you immediately go over there?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
Fucker.
Him, Albert...
Well, the asshole's got his head in the clouds. Basically. Permanently. Mm-hmm. Fester's got his head in the stars.
Wait, which maybe is, maybe I can't do that right
which
now.
Is not a bad place.
Maybe I have to attempt to leave? And come back or something?
Tiberoa. The Twin Castle.
In Fabia?
Felts. Flets. Flets or something.
I have to get up and stretch.
My foot, like, starting to fall. My foot, I tried to stand on it. It was like, nope.
It's Tarzan all over again. No.
Yep.
No, I remember the beginning and I remember the boss, but I don't remember how to get there. I remember there's a boss and I know.
I remember there's a boss and I remember the beginning.
We soar never again.
I don't think this will be quite that bad.
Won't be. What is that?
It's a dude in a dress.
It's a kilt.
Have you ever seen someone playing a game that looks so, like, half asleep? Because his eyes are like that.
Thank
like...
you? Hey, is that a racist slur? A racial slur?
His eyes are like...
Trying to say the most slanty?
They're like the most closed you can be while still being open. That's what you were like.
My eyes have not been this closed playing a game.
Where you look like you could literally just slip into sleep at any minute for a while
there.
There
it is. I forgot, I have to follow him around. I can't just go shoot yourself. I have to, like, run into him until he's done all of his errands.
Yeah. No, because you're the solution!
To the errands.
Oh, here we go. Now he's like, I'm done. You can come to my house.
But the problem's right there!
I know.
It's here, wait!
Why didn't you tell me? Because you fucking asshole!